represent a bunch of students doing something.
WSMC first went on the air 50 years ago this month. In those years, we've gone from FM 88.1 Collegedale to Chattanooga Public Radio, possibly 90.5 WSMC Collegedale, Tennessee. We used to have a 10-watt antenna that would barely get past Linwood Hall, but now we have 100,000 watts, transmitting great classical music almost the whole way to Atlanta. If you've worked under those famed four call letters, you do your best to remember the good days, but you can't help but remember those days that you'd rather forget. This is one of those days. Josh is scheduled to work classical commute this morning for Tyler, but he's running a little bit late. What he doesn't realize is that there's no music playing. Let's look it up.
I thought Tyler was supposed to play my music. What do you mean you? I've just got like 2 minutes. I don't have time to play my whole hour. I know. I'll just play my billboard, and I guess I'll just play the rest during the BBC News.
Josh decided on a Bach organ piece for his feature piece of music. He's got just a few moments to program his CD and practice his billboard. He has to be very careful not to take too long, though, since BBC News waits for no man. Here he is now.
The father of the symphony and string quartet, Franz Joseph Haydn, is known today as an Austrian composer. However, Johann Sebastian Bach was often asked to write easy piano pieces. So, to be obliging, he would write one, or at least start something. He would start with an easy theme, then work it out so it was almost always too hard. Upon hearing complaints, he would smile and say, "Only practice it diligently. It will go very well. You have 5 just as healthy fingers on each man's eye. In this hour, I will play you a little bit of organ music by Bach after the BBC News."
BBC News, Moscow. Ja, Ukrainskaya. Chattanooga Obshchet Mirnogo Radio, Klasikicheskaya 95, Rezdu mnie svoje, Kalyeset, Nietzsche, Svobodny Vecher.
What is Josh supposed to do? No one in the listening audience will understand the Russian news update, but at the same time, he has to get this hour of music planned. He decides to leave the news on. He can't be penalized for doing what he's supposed to.
I hope you enjoyed your language lesson there. You're tuned in to Joshua Farmer. You're tuned in to Classical Commute here on Classical 90.5. I'm your host, Joshua Farnsworth. Let's begin this hour with a collection from a piece from our large collection of records. The first piece we're going to be listening today is by Hildegarda Bingham, one of the first women composers in recorded history. This is her piece, O Virtus Sapientiae.
The record player, unfortunately, is set to 45 revolutions per minute instead of 33 and a third.
We just heard Hildegarda Bingham's O Virtus Sapientiae performed by the Chipmunks. Support for programming here in Class 9.5 comes from Friedrich's Funeral Home, located in downtown Chattanooga. If you bring us a body, we'll take care of it. No questions asked. You are tuned in to Classical Commute. Stay tuned with us in 5 minutes for more news by the BBC. But right now, let's listen to some nice music of Petrucci.
Josh picked a piece of music that should last long enough to bring him right to the news break. However, what he doesn't realize is that the CD case was mislabeled. He's playing awful 20th century music instead of the wonderful melodies he was hoping for. Whatever will he do?
Great. Nothing's been going right this morning. I'm pretty sure Billy's just gonna fire me. I've got an idea. Pause. Play. Pause. Play. Pause. We'll try and get that fixed for you the best way possible we can. Now, I've got 3 minutes of dead air, no music to play. Here we go. You're tuned in to Chattanooga Public Radio, Class 190.5, WSMC, Collegedale, Tennessee. Listener supported, public radio. We're broadcasting from the campus of Southern Adventist University and have been doing so for the last 50 years. Stay with me for a little bit of Bach music coming up after this next news break. Right now, let's have a look at the weather. Currently, we have a 50% chance of weather with highs of about 70 degrees and a low of 40. Sorry, I was reading in Celsius. Let's have a look now at WSMC's 12-day forecast. We can expect highs near 75 degrees, and it's going to be sunny. The evenings, well, you can expect it to be a little cooler. 5 to 10 mile an hour winds with a dew point of 12. We hope you love what you hear here on Class 190.5, but we do need your feedback, so give us a call, toll free at 1-866-90.5-WSMC. If you're a local listener, you can call us at our local line, 423-236-2905. You can also mail us things if you'd like. We hear the station like cookies. The address you can send those to is P.O. Box 370, Collegedale, Tennessee, 37315. If you'd like to fax us, that's an option as well. Also, my number is 555-1235. Although our fall member drive ended 2 weeks ago, you can still become a member. All you have to do is go online and click on the Donate Now button. Also, you can contact us at any of those previous options. Stay tuned with us now for the BBC News.
Josh crosses himself, then pulls up BBC News. He doesn't know whether to expect it in English, or Russian, or Creole, or Malagasy.
BBC News America, I'm Diane Sawyer. The BBC has just confirmed that virtuoso violinist Joshua Bell has died. He was presumed dead several years ago on April 1, but those rumors were false. We here at the BBC would like to extend our condolences to his friends and family. The Baroque Musicians Association Against Period Instruments, or Anti-Bach, has officially canonized two great keyboardists. Organist E. Power Biggs and pianist Glenn Gould were made saints by the offshoot group who formally denounced Johann Sebastian Bach. BBC News.
Welcome back to Classical Commute here on Class 190.5. I'm your host, Joshua Farnsworth. Let's listen now to that Bach piece that I've been promising you. This is Johann Sebastian Bach's Partita No. 2 in H. dur for Suite 3 on the orchestra.
This probably wasn't the best piece for Josh to play on a morning shift. He's tired, the piece is slow and long and melodic. He's got 23 minutes. He's looking pretty tired. See? He can't even keep his eyes open. Just lay down. It's okay. Nothing can possibly go wrong.
Stop it! I'm here with my husband!
But how can you stay with him? He's been in an asylum!
And nobody here is our dear friend, Sir Louis.
Speak up a little. Blessed be America, battery bang out. Blessed be a chunk of anything.
Well, I suppose I'm glad you're all here, although I'm not really sure why. But, while you're here, do you have any advice for me?
You should play much organ music, and you should play music that's more accessible and melodic, like music of my dear Clara Wieck.
Clara Wieck? Schumann Wieck. She is there to be, you know. And you, you play too much of the three Bs, too much Brahms. Variety is the key to playing music.
Amen.
Always check and recheck your pronunciation. Nothing makes you sound more foolish than announcing the He Brides Overture when you meet Hebrides. Also, make sure you know the full name of a composer. Because if you don't, you'll be announcing Placido. Placido.
And remember, learn a bit of German so you don't sound foolish when you say H2. It's Ach, Ach, yeah. It's B major, anyway. But I want you to remember these three letters. S, D, G. Sorry, dear bloody. Only to God be the blood. Now, you don't have to say this over the air, but your listeners can get anything. Just try to remember that.
Well, thank you, everyone. You know what? I really try to, but sometimes it just forgets me in the moment with all the stress and all. What about you, Herr Beethoven? Do you have any words of wisdom for me?
Huh? But what made me successful? But I've been applying to the good, you know, for the feeling.
That sounds like the off air alarm.
That was Johann Sebastian Bach's Partita number 2 in Achtur for the organ, performing was Seats of the Breeze. As I mentioned earlier, you tuned into Classical Commute, and we here at WSMC have been broadcasting for the past 50 years. And I know, just like me, all of you have had a little bit of problems during your shift at the radio station. So if you have any of your memories, whether you've played the wrong record or you've left the microphone on, maybe you have some here. Well, we have a get-together in the back. We have some refreshments, so we'd like to invite you all to join us for some refreshments and share your memories. Thank you.